Hi guys, welcome back to United Star. This is a brief of our FPL show that we're going to hold every week now since the game weeks are back and it's going to be better than ever. So first, let's start off with the new rule changes. I think the most important rule change that's happened is there are now unlimited transfers, and that's very important to note down. Also, another thing to note is your tokens will not refresh. So if you've used things like Triple Captain or Bench Boost, they will not refresh and they will remain used. So plan accordingly. The first and most important question is what type of teams to look out for? Because the fixture list is now very spread in the sense of there are no Europa League or Champions League games in the middle. So we can pick players from top six teams who might have otherwise shuffled. And there's also going to be a fight in the relegation team. So Prasham, why don't you get us started?
I think like Rishi said, you should look for teams that are going for a Champions League spot or are going for a Europa League spot or are going or are battling relegation. I think in this part of the season, we've seen over years that it is the best bet is to pick from these and you get budget players and that score heavy points. So the defense you might want to pick from relegation teams because they generally try to keep clean sheets and pinch a goal and win games. And the Champions League teams that are going for Champions League have a mix of a good defense and attack. So that's the first thing. There are three teams I think you should definitely avoid are Brighton, Crystal Palace and Sheffield. I think they have the hardest fixtures. And one team I think you should look out for, I think two teams that you should look out for is United. Manchester United have Leicester and Spurs. Other fixtures are really easy. And Wolves and Wolverhampton Wanderers or Wolves, they are very easy fixtures. So I think this is what I'd say in terms of teams.
Farhan?
Yeah, I agree with Prasham. I think you should just avoid the mid-table teams who have nothing to fight for. Rather go for teams that have something to fight for, like Europe, you know, Champions League and Europa League, and the relegation teams, because historically we've seen Sunderland, Newcastle, all these teams perform very well at the tail end of the season. So I think, yeah, we should go for players from the relegation zone or people that are from teams that are competing for a European spot.
Okay, so why don't you all name three teams, barring the likes of Cities, United and Chelsea's, who you think are important to have players from? I think I'll pick the first team, which I think both of you will agree with, is Everton.
Yeah. I'd agree with Everton. Yeah, and I'd say Wolves. And I would go for a team like... Actually, I think Everton and Wolves, you'd go out for... You can double up on. And then a team you could consider is something like Norwich, West Ham, or Aston Villa, or even Newcastle United. One of these, I think I'm more gung-ho on Newcastle United because defensively, they have a good record. At home, at least.
Farhan, what about you?
Yeah, completely agree. So, I'd go with Everton. I'd definitely go with Wolves. And the third is like a roll of a dice. You can just pick one of the teams Prasham mentioned. I'd probably go with Newcastle too because they have a very good defensive record. So, probably Martin Dubravka from there is a very good pick, I think. And he's a very cheap pick also. So, yeah, Newcastle, Everton and Wolves.
Okay, so let's move on quickly to the formation that you guys will pick and the players in those formations. So, Prasham, why don't you get us started?
I think let's go with the players first. So I think my two goalkeepers I would go with are Nick Pope. Of course, I think for his price, he's an excellent choice to have. And I think most people have him. He's not even a differential anymore. And his fixture list is very easy. So you blindly go in with him. But I think the second keeper, I would go for someone who's a playing goalkeeper. So I might be tempted to go for Dean Henderson because he makes a lot of saves every game. A very good candidate for bonus points. And Sheffield, they might not win many games, but they do keep a lot of clean sheets even against the big teams. So I would go for Henderson and Pope. Another option to consider might be Alex McCarthy from Southampton. He's also a cheap option. But the main thing I think managers should focus on is having two goalkeepers that will be playing. Because that will make a big difference. I think going for someone like Edison or De Gea or an expensive goalkeeper is not a good idea. I think go for two goalkeepers who are playing.
Farhan, two goalkeepers?
Yep, completely agreed. So yeah, my two goalkeepers, my first goalkeeper, Nick Pope, I completely agree with Prasham. He's a 4.9, not a differential, but it's a no-brainer basically. For that price, for 4.9 million, Nick Pope is like a fix. And my second pick is Martin Dubravka from Newcastle. Because I think they've been keeping a good amount of clean sheets at home, number one. And Dubravka statistically has the highest number of saves. Or if not the highest, he's up there definitely. So he'll get you bonus points too. So my two picks for goalkeeper are Pope and Dubravka.
Okay, let's move on to five midfielders. Prasham?
Defenders, Rishi. Five defenders.
Sorry, five defenders. My bad.
So in defenders, I'd go for a strategy where I'd want to pick a I want to pick more wing backs, more than center backs. I know that center backs tend to score headers, but I'm more keen on picking wing backs. So one player I think you must have, just because not that he might get many points, but when he does, you'll hit, take a huge hit, is Trent Alexander-Arnold. He's expensive, but I think he goes into the team directly because he brings, if you don't have him, there's a lot to lose. If there might not be a lot to gain, but there's definitely a lot to lose. The second midfield defensive player I'd go for is Matt Doherty from Wolverhampton's. Doherty, however you pronounce his name. He's 6.3. Again, like Arnold, I think he's very good on the wings and he gets a lot of goals and assists for Wolves. So he's an attacking outlet. So you could go for him. I would go for a United defender. I think you must have a United defender in your team. So you pick between Maguire and Van der Sar on what you prefer, centre-back or a left-back or a wing-back. So both are 5.3, a great price for a player that plays for a top club like Manchester United. And United's fixtures are easy, like I said. So I assume that they will keep a lot of clean sheets. So you must have one of them. My differential defender will be Mason Holgate from Everton. Yari Mina is injured and doesn't look like he's going to come back. So Mason Holgate is going to get a lot of game time. Everton have very good fixtures and he's 4.3. His value is very less and I think he'd do a good job as my fifth defender. And another defender I'd pick is an option. I'd go maybe for a Newcastle United defender or a Burnley defender again, or even a Sheffield defender. A Sheffield defender, maybe the likes of Baldock, Basham, Lundstrom are all good options because the attacking value they bring. They're essentially who play as midfielders, but they're listed as defenders on FPL. So they bring a lot of value. All three of them have scored a lot of points. And Newcastle, you could take your pick. I think Federico Fernandez has got the most points, so you can go with him. He's 4.6. So yeah, this is what I'd pick. But I think Lundstrom or one of the Sheffield defenders might be yet a good option because they also have the first week as a double game week for them.
Aran, what about you?
Yeah, completely agree with Prasham on picking more attacking fullbacks rather than centre backs. So that's why even I think you should pick Matt Doherty. I think he should be a fix in basically every defense because he gets plenty of points going forward. Also, clean sheet-wise, Wolves are very tight defensively. So, Matt Doherty is a no-brainer for me. Even Sheffield United, from Sheffield United, you can get Lundstrom because he's more a midfielder, but he's listed as a defender in FPL. So, yeah, Lundstrom, Doherty, and from Manchester United, definitely get a defender. I'd go with prefer Maguire over Wan-Bissaka because Wan-Bissaka, he... You know, offensively, he's not as good as he's defensively. And Maguire will get you the odd headed goal. So I think I'd prefer, and they're the same price. So I'd rather go for Maguire than go for Wan-Bissaka. And my differential defenders, I'll go with Jamal Lascelles from Newcastle, 4.3. And Newcastle have been keeping plenty of clean sheets at home. But I think Lascelles is a good pick. And yeah, you can go with Holgate or Trent Alexander-Arnold as your fifth defender.
I'd just like to say a lot
depending
of
on what you want.
I just like to say a lot of people are tempted to go with two Liverpool defenders, but I don't think that's a good option because I feel go with one, either Van Dijk or Arnold. I think Arnold is a must. Van Dijk has not been scoring as many goals this season. Robertson is one player that might be rotated a lot, but Arnold is the player who might not be rotated as much because Liverpool don't have a specialist right back. So that's why don't get into the trap of buying two expensive Liverpool defenders is what I'd say.
Okay, yeah, let's completely agree. Now move on to the five midfielders. Farhan, we'll start with you this time.
Okay, so De Bruyne is a fix because he is going to assist every score and assist every second goal. I think he's on course to breaking Andre's record. Probably might break it. So yeah, De Bruyne is a no-brainer. We should be having him in the midfield. In terms, I think Bruno Fernandes is a good option to have in midfield. You know, before the break started, I think he was in a very rich winner form. And I think he's going to continue, so you know, with his good form. So I think you should have Bruno Fernandes in the midfield. As a differential, I think you should have Jack Grealish. You know, he's a cheap option, 6.4 or 6.5. I don't know how many better midfielders you'll get than Jack Grealish. So yeah, and he gets, you know, the odd goal, the odd assist, and Aston Villa in a relegation battle. And I think he's their main player, their key player. So I think Jack Grealish is a very good option. Richarlison for me too. Everton, you know, playing attacking football under Carlo, scoring plenty of goals. So I think Richarlison as my fourth midfielder. And my fifth midfielder would be Harvey Barnes from Leicester City. I know he's not as flashy as the other Leicester players, Madison and all, but, you know, he gets the odd goal, he gets the assist. So might as well even pick Harvey Barnes. So this will be my five. De Bruyne, Richarlison, Grealish, Fernandes and Harvey Barnes.
Okay, yeah. So my five, of course, I'm not going to say much on De Bruyne. De Bruyne has to be in your team. As Trent Alexander-Arnold, De Bruyne has explosive weeks, and when he explodes, you don't want to miss out. So De Bruyne is a no-brainer. I'd also say one of Salah or Mane is a no-brainer. Personally, I'd go with Salah, 12.7, a little expensive, but he'll be on penalty duties. He scores a lot of goals, expected goals, big chances, and the number of goals scored is also quite high for Mohamed Salah. I think he's in the top five for all of those things. And one of them, I think, is a must-have because Liverpool are yet a very good team. So I'd go with De Bruyne or Salah as my two main midfielders, with Bruno as being the budget option as a very good points output because he's 8.6. And he's shown that what he can do and he's involved in everything. And I personally think he'll yet be on penalties even though Pogba and Rashford are back. And he also takes the corners, right? So I think Bruno is going to be a great asset to have. And I think all managers should have him because, again, United, cheap, very, very easy fixture list. In my differentials, I'd want to go for Adama Traore. I think he's an explosive player. Wolves, again, an easy fixture list. And he's the kind of player who can get you three, four goals a game. Goals in two games, and he can get a lot of assists. His pace is explosive. He creates a lot of chances. So I'd go with Adama Traore, and Harvey Barnes has basically been my pick for a long time now. I think he's the most sensible Leicester buy. Rishi knows this. He's the most sensible Leicester buy, I think, and I agree with Ferran on that. I don't think anything else makes sense. And a couple of options I'd like to give the people is Sar from Watford. I think he's having a terrific season, especially after Nigel Pearson has taken over, and he's really unleashing Sar as a good player. And Todd Cantwell from Norwich. These two players are really cheap and really good options. I might be a little conservative on Jack Grealish. I don't want him in my five right now because he's coming back from a disciplinary issue as well. And also, Aston Villa have some tough fixtures. I don't think they're going to stay in the Premier League. They're most likely to go down. They have a lot of tough fixtures. I think they have three or four tough fixtures. And that's the only reason I wouldn't have Grealish. But yeah, these essentially. And you could also go for Fleck. Fleck, I think, is a good option in midfield, especially for the first game week. Cause like Lundstrom, even he has a double game week. And Sheffield midfielders always have that one defensive point anyway. You can take that for a guarantee almost now. So yeah, so that would be my midfield five. I personally would go for De Bruyne, Bruno, Salah, Barnes, Traore or Fleck.
Okay, and last but not the least, the most expensive of the lot, the strikers.
I think you'd take a balanced view to strikers. I wouldn't overspend on them because I'd rather have Salah, De Bruyne and Bruno, all three in my midfield, than have an expensive striker. So my strategy is going to be to have Dominic Calvert-Lewin for sure. So I'll have two Everton players that way. Dominic Calvert-Lewin, since Ancelotti has come in, he's combined beautifully with Richarlison. And they both get roughly the same number of goals. That's why I don't pick Richarlison, because Richarlison, as Ferran said, is 8.3. DCL is 6.2. So I think Dominic Calvert-Lewin is a no-brainer. He has to be in your squad. The second player I'd go for is another budget buy between, I'd say, Jordan Ayew or Timo Pukki. Jordan Ayew has a tough run of fixtures, but he's 5.1, so you might consider him. Timo Pukki has shown that he can do well. He's 6.5. He's scored a lot of goals. Norwich are battling relegation. They have some easy fixtures in which you expect them to score goals, even if they lose. I mean, they lose 4-3 to City or something like that. So they get goals. And another budget option you might consider is Danny Ings. It's not very expensive. He's in that sort of budget price range, and he's getting bonus points. He's scoring goals. He's up there on goals scored and expected goals as well. And he doesn't miss many chances. Big chances missed for Ings is very less. So Danny Ings. For my main striker, for game week 30 plus, I'm going to go with Aubameyang because he has two games and he is one of the most prolific strikers in the league. Bonus points for Arsenal is Aubameyang's the leader. Expected goals, chances created and big chances taken for Arsenal, Aubameyang's the highest. And he's also in the strikers list. I think he's third in that. So I think I'd go for Aubameyang, but I would sell him off in game week 31 and get Jimenez in from Wolves again. I'll save some money, which I can invest later. I think I'll need it later. And I think Jimenez is a very good option because Jimenez is, again, a Wolves player, easy fixtures. So I might even triple up on Wolves, as you can see. And he is, again, a must-have in your team for, I think, 8.1 his prices. And I think Jimenez and DCL are the two strikers you must have.
Yeah, completely agreed. I think Jimenez and DCL, they're both in my team too. And I think it's a no-brainer that you must pick DCL and Jimenez because they've both got easy fixtures. They both get plenty of goals. So yeah, it makes complete sense to Jimenez and DCL. As a third option, there are many options, but I prefer Danny Ings because since Southampton got thrashed by Leicester City 9-1, you know, they've turned around a corner and they've been playing very well since then. You know, it's been up and down, but Ings has been in the, you know, he's been up there with the top goal scorer. So I definitely pick Danny Ings. Yeah, for this particular game week, I would agree with Prashant. You should go with Aubameyang because, you know, he's definitely going to be scoring or assisting. So Aubameyang, I'll get for this game week, and then I would immediately sell him off because they don't have easy fixtures after that. So yeah, these are my attacking three, forward three options.
Okay, and now the most important decision, which is the captain pick. For me personally, I'm always in the question of, should you gamble with your captain pick or should you pick a safe captain pick? Like a gamble would probably be like betting on Trent Alexander-Arnold to score and get a clean sheet. Or should you play it safe and get a goal or an odd assist from Salah?
No, I think this is the week to play it safe. I think double game week, Arsenal and City. And the top two, I'd say the top two options are number one, Kevin De Bruyne, and number two, Aubameyang. And you could look at them in any way. I think you can look at them in any way, but I think it has to be one of them because Kevin De Bruyne is playing Arsenal and then Burnley. Aubameyang is playing City and then Brighton. Both of them are... So, De Bruyne is playing both games at home. So, I think that's why I pip it to Kevin De Bruyne. Also, every goal he scores is worth 1 point more than Aubameyang, and obviously, he gets more assists than Aubameyang anyway. And even if City likely to keep a clean sheet against Burnley, at least, I think. So, that's another point. So, looking at everything, I think Kevin De Bruyne has to be your captain this week. If you have not used your double captain chip, triple captain chip, I think this might be an option to pick pick Kevin De Bruyne. I think it's a great chance for all the managers out there to use it because De Bruyne, Arsenal, you saw, have lost to Brentford 3-2 and defensively, they're a mess anyway. So, De Bruyne might be capitalizing on that as well. And the other option, if you don't own De Bruyne, then I'd go with Aubameyang because Aubameyang is a great option as well. Because again, double game week, likely to get a lot of points, likely to score goals. And finally, the third one I'd go for is always safe. The always safe option I see is to go for a player like Jimenez because Jimenez is playing against West Ham. And West Ham, you don't know what West Ham will turn up, but I think Wolves will win that game 1-0 or 2-1. And I expect Jimenez to get a goal at least. So that would be my safe pick if you don't own De Bruyne or Aubameyang either.
Ferran, your picks?
Yeah. So Kevin De Bruyne for me. Because obviously he's got the double game week now, and he's I think he likes playing against Arsenal. You saw in the first fixture this season he was phenomenal against Arsenal. He was just brilliant.
I was there for that game. I can vouch for that.
Yeah, he was pretty good. Yeah, and yeah, so I'd in fact double up on De Bruyne. I think it's worth the risk because I think he's going to play very well against Arsenal, and he's got the second game against Burnley, which I think he'll also get a goal or assist over there. So De Bruyne, definitely, I think he's the best option to have right now. If not De Bruyne, then yeah, definitely Raul Jimenez because he's got easy fixtures and he always gets the odd goal. So choice number one, De Bruyne. Choice number two, Jimenez for me.
One last tip I'd like to give for this week is don't load up on defenders. I'm expecting a lot of goals this week. Everyone's coming back. I see some very huge defensive lapses from players. So I'd rather go with a 3-5-2 formation or a 3-4-3 formation. I think that's the best way forward.
I'm going against both of you and I'm going to captain Trent Alexander-Arnold.
This is why, Rishi, I'm beating you.
You're just lucky. Okay, anyways, guys, this is all we have for this week. Tune in next week. During the same time, and we'll bring you an analysis of what happened last week and more picks for the next game week. See you guys.
We'll also see who did the best out of the three.
Yeah.